In book 19 of the Iliad, it's the next morning, and Thetis delivers Achilles new armor. This gives him strength, and he promises to keep Patroclus' body from decaying. He calls his army together and renounces his rage toward Agamemnon. He now intends to immediately go into battle. Agamemnon also speaks, blaming the gods for his actions and promising Achilles the formerly offered treasures and the return of Perseus. Achilles is eager to start fighting immediately. Odysseus insists the army needs food to fight. Agamemnon quickly delivers the promised treasures. Achilles will not eat, so Athena fuels him for battle with the food and drink of the gods, ambrosia and nectar. He dons his new armor and boards his chariot, and he scolds his immortal horses to keep him alive better than they did Patroclus. One horse replies, given a voice by Hera, that they will save him once more, but they cannot fight Achilles' fate that is coming soon. Achilles isn't moved. He has already chosen his fate. The conflict that has driven the story to this point is resolved as Achilles reconciles with Agamemnon. The resolution is not due to any character growth on Achilles' part. He's only changed the target of his rage from Agamemnon to Hector. He continues to disregard the needs of his own army. He feels everyone should be in mourning. Odysseus points out if soldiers were always fasting to mourn their fallen comrades, they would never be able to fuel themselves for the next day's battle. They have to be able to move on to fight and win glory. Eating represents acceptance that life goes on, even after the most tragic events. Achilles' rejection of food is the rejection of life itself. To sustain him through battle, the gods grant him the privilege of living off their own food and drink, emphasizing his nature as being half mortal and half god. Agamemnon pledges to reward Achilles for returning to battle. He continues to deflect responsibility for his actions, blaming them on the goddess of ruin. Even Achilles blames his anger on the gods. Agamemnon's decision seems less like madness and more like selfishness.